Hello everyone. After started your Shopify store, sometimes you feel like this. Why no one is buying our products from our store? I created this video help to this type of issues. How to increase our sales? I want to give you 12 important points. You think about these points and analyze yourself with your store. So it will help you to improve your store performance and get more visitors and sales. The first point, no one is buying your products from your store because maybe you don't use any brandable logo. So create a stunning logo first. In Shopify itself, give you a free platform, you can create your logo. You can use this hful.shopify.com to creating your logo. This is a Shopify logo maker tool. If you not already a logo, first do that. Create your strong brand logo. The next point, you recheck your store and remove existing logo from your existing product photos. Always you promote your product photos individually with not include any logos or unwanted text on there, because customers want the product specifically on the photos. See, we don't need to add our logos and other unwanted text in the product image. If you do already that, just remove that. Or just replace new product photos. The third point, name your price. Our names are complete, a whole value, right? Similar like that, we just put our product prices a complete decimal value, not in points. For example, just put your product price as $99. Don't put your product price is 99.95 price. That's what I'm saying. The next point you consider, place your policies in your footer area. Privacy policy, terms and conditions, shipping policy. These policy pages you just put in the footer area, not in the top of your website. You can create your policies from Shopify itself. They are providing free tools. So from these tools, we can generate our privacy policy and a lot of important policies from this tools section. The next important thing is you need to check most of the time about your product inventory. Update your product inventory regularly. If some products are out of stock, just hide those products from the store design. In front of the customer view, they don't know about the particular product is in stock or out of stock. So you need to keep watching those products. Better you can set this automatically in your Shopify store. If any product become out of stock, those products not automatically displayed in the store. They will automatically disabled. After that product comes again in stock, that will automatically show to the customers. We can do this in Shopify itself. Then next important point you check in your store is define your marketing plan. You must have a marketing plan, then only you can success. If you don't have any marketing plan, you can't promote your products, so you can't get any sales. You need a marketing plan. It may be a free plan or paid promotion. You need a marketing plan and do every day. Then only you can boost your sales. The next point, optimize your store across devices. We create our store with responsiveness. What is responsiveness? Our web page, our store pages display in all devices without any issues, because customers access our store in any devices because they are multiple customers from multiple directions. Someone prefer to view our store in desktop, someone from laptop, someone from mobile phone, someone from tablet. So we prepare our site, we create our store to support responsively for all devices. That's very important. If you fail in this future, that's a high possibility to missing a massive group of customers from our store. Because we're receiving a small amount of customers. First there comes like visitors, those visitors only converted to customers. So small group of visitors, the conversion rate very low. So we optimize our store very mobile friendly and it can access across all devices. That's very important. The next thing, fast track your store with ready-made products. We don't need to all products keep inventory with us. We can use Weberlo. For example, we only have 10 to 20 products only in our hand, but we can add some more products from Weberlo. So we can show our store with 50 to 60 products. Weberlo is a dropshipping app. It promotes the AliExpress products. So these are ready-made products just added in your store. It helpful customer to creating a customer trust with us, because the customer will believe and imagine this store promoting lot of products. I'm not inform you to sell thousands of products in your store, but you just keep the products at 20 to 50 products is enough to start up. The next point, don't mess with the theme, because some people are lot of updations doing on the theme. Mostly the theme basic file is very clean and simple, but they are messed up. We must keep our store very simple and very user friendly. That's very important. We don't need to force and put all unwanted items in one place. The next point, offer multiple payment options. Shopify gives you a lot of opportunities to receive payments. The customers not using a single payment system, so lot of customers preferring multiple systems from their ability and the opportunity they have. So we must offer multiple payment options for them. The next point, build in SEO optimized blog. Build an SEO optimized blog. Every Shopify store have a blog section, so we need to post regularly on the blog section. That's helpful to the customers to read lot of information and they will improve their knowledge. So we need to help to purchase product indirectly from our store. So we create a blog with SEO friendly. So our blog posts are already SEO friendly. They are high possibility to display in the search engine results. For search engines, we don't need to pay any fees. It's completely free traffic. It's like a one-time investment. We just invest our time and build our blog post with the SEO optimized. So it will regularly send visitors to our store from our blog post. This is the power of search engines. So we must use this feature. The next point, give free shipping. People are like to get the product and without any extra cost. So if we keep our pricing including the shipping cost, that's a high chances to make more sales. We can do one thing, we include the shipping cost in the product cost. We add the shipping cost into our product cost. Then only we can give free shipping. So you consider these 12 points. If anything you missed, just optimize your blog according to these points. Surely you can increase your sales and make more money from your Shopify store. I hope this video is helpful. See you on next video. Until then, thank you very much.